It's not crystal. It's just another custom. Damn, what's taking us so long?
I don't know. But she said she'd be right back, didn't she?
Yeah. She said she was going back to her hotel to get some papers that'd tell me about my parents. I mean, how long could that take?
Maybe she changed her mind about telling you.
No. She knows how important this is to me. She knows how much I need to know about my family.
Maybe you know enough. I mean, you know that your dad was white and that he didn't want to marry your mother.
Because she was black.
Right. And you know that your mom gave you up for adoption. I mean, and look how upset it's gotten you. Maybe you just don't need to know anymore.
No, Whitney, I need to know everything. Okay, I need to know who I am. I mean, for all I know, I could have brothers and sisters out there. Nah, I'll wait. That must be Crystal now. Yo, excuse me. I'm still waiting over here for Crystal, and I thought I might have missed seeing her come back. She ain't in her dressing room, is she?
No, she hasn't come back.
You saying you ain't seen her since she left?
Last time I seen her, she was heading for the wharf. Seemed to have a lot on her mind. Excuse me.
No luck, huh?
Nah. Why's she hanging me up like this? Wait a minute. The manager said she was on her way to the wharf, not here. Didn't your dad say that your mom got a call about a shooting on the wharf?
Yeah, he said that. I think it was some woman. Oh, no. You don't think it was Crystal?
Oh, my God. I hope to hell not. But why didn't she come back here? I mean, she had more than enough time to go to the hotel and get back here.
No, you're right.
I have to go to the wharf. I gotta see who got shot. I heard a woman got shot at the wharf. Any idea who it was?
It was that singer, Crystal.
Oh, my God. She gonna be all right?
She's dead, Chad.
I saw Ethan leaving when Chad and I got here. What's he doing here?
I called Ethan when I thought that the victim might be Sheridan.
Well, so where is Gwen? You said that when you left the Crane Mansion, he and Gwen were together.
Well, he left Gwen asleep. He was so worried that the person who was shot might be Sheridan.
Because that's what you told him, of course, so you could get him down here.
No, I really thought it was Sheridan. I mean, Hank came over and told Luis that he left Sheridan down here at the wharf alone. So when Luis got the call about a woman being shot down here, well, he thought it was Sheridan.
So that's why you called him.
Yes. And he really needed me, Whitney.
You just got through telling me that you were through dreaming about Ethan. That now that Gwen's back, it's over.
But you should have been here. You should have seen how affected Ethan was when I put my arms around him to comfort him.
And why did he leave?
Because he is still not ready to admit his feelings for me. I know that he wants to be with me. And I know that deep down, he loves me. If only I had another week, you know? Even a day. I know that Ethan and I could reconnect and maybe I could get him to open up and admit that he loves me.
But Gwen is back.
Yeah. And now it's too late.
So, are you telling me that you're finally giving up on Ethan?
I don't have a chance with you. With Gwen here. I don't have a choice.
It never stopped you before.
I know I have said this to you before, Whitney. But this time, I mean it. I have no choice but to give up on Ethan for good. I mean, time has run out for me. Gwen is here to stay until the wedding.
I am so sorry, Teresa. I do know how badly this hurts you. It's been such a sad day for everyone. I mean, you lost Ethan, Crystal lost her life, and Chad lost out on the chance to find out who his real parents are.
I feel so sorry for Chad. And for you.
Me? Why?
You won't admit it, Whitney, but I know you. And if Chad is hurting, you're hurting too because you like him. I can tell by the way you keep looking at him. Teresa, I was not looking at Chad, okay?
Yes, you were.
Well, so? Look, I told you. I just feel sorry because now he's not going to find out who his real parents are.
I feel sorry for Chad, too. But that's not all you're feeling.
I do not have the same kind of feeling that you have with Ethan, okay?
But I don't think anyone can feel the way I feel about Ethan. But you're getting close, and the next step is admitting it to yourself.
Now look, Teresa, you're driving me crazy with this. You're letting your imagination run wild. I told you, I feel sorry for him. I don't have the hots for him. I don't want him to be my boyfriend or anything.
Okay, so you don't know what you're missing.
Oh, what am I missing, Teresa? Being miserable all the time like you are over Ethan? Thank you, but I'm happy to miss that.
I admit that loving someone who doesn't love you back is miserable. But I imagine that loving someone and feeling loved in return is like the best feeling in the world, and it's worth everything I've gone through to get it.
Well, maybe you're right. I do see the way that my parents love each other. I see the way that Chief and Mrs. Bennett love each other. It looks like it's a wonderful feeling.
You see?
Yeah. And I'm looking forward to feeling that way someday, Teresa. When I'm a grown woman and I meet the right man. But for now, nothing beats the feeling I get when I win a tennis match. Right now, boys are just gonna have to wait.
I just hope you don't make them wait too long, Whitley, or else they'll fall in love with someone else.
Well, the last thing I would want is for a man that I love to be in love with someone else. Okay, look, Teresa, what are you going to do? Now that Gwen is back, and she's going to be with Ethan till the wedding.
The only thing I can do, Whitney, pray for a miracle.